Hello friends, already in my previous video I have discussed in detail about polynomial multiplication using convolution. Okay, now in this video I am going to explain how you can use that concept using FFT. Okay, so polynomial multiplication using FFT, if someone give you this question, how you can write the code, that's what I am going to discuss. So basically, from my previous video, you know that polynomial multiplication can be done using convolution. If you don't know, please check the link given in the description. Already in my previous video, I have explained in detail. And also, I have explained that convolution can be done, that is linear convolution can be done using FFT. If we perform linear convolution using FFT, then that is termed as first convolution. And how to write a MATLAB code for first convolution, that also I have discussed in my previous video. If you want to know the detailed explanation, that link will be provided in the description, you can check. So that concept we can use for polynomial multiplication. So basically there are two steps. Number one concept, we know that polynomial multiplication can be done using convolution, and convolution can be done using FFT. So directly in step two, what we can do, compute polynomial multiplication result using FFT. That's all. So see, this is the simple code to compute the linear convolution using FFT, or you can say this algorithm as first convolution. So see, simple code, already I have explained. Again, I am giving a quick recap. CLC, clear all, close all. X1 and input enter the first sequence. X2 and input enter the second sequence. Okay. N equal to length of X1 of N. M equal to length of X2 of N. S equal to N plus M minus 1. And then basically we have to compute S point FFT or DFT, you can say. So X1 of K is equal to FFT of X1 of N comma S. X2 of K is equal to FFT of X2 of N comma X. So we have computed FFT of two input sequence X1N and X2N. Then we have multiplied, and then we have taken inverse FFT. That's all. This is how we compute linear convolution using circular convolution or linear convolution using FFT, right? So that's what I have written. Same code only. So let me show you. Control A, evaluate selection. So now see, let me take these two polynomials, x square plus 1. So first polynomial coefficient, first polynomial is what? X square plus 1, right? So x square plus 1, if you write the coefficients, you have to write like this, x square. So 1, then polynomial of polynomial x, in this particular polynomial, x is not present. So 0 into x we can assume. So coefficient of x is 0 and 1. Okay, so this is our polynomial coefficient for the first polynomial. Okay. So let me paste this here. Okay, and enter the second. So second one is x plus 1. Now you can see here x plus 1. So x square coefficient is not present. So 0 for x square, 1 for x, 1 for 1. Okay, so now our result will be stored in which variable? See here, x3 of n, right? So let me write x3 of n. If I press enter, see what coefficients we are getting. The polynomial multiplication coefficients are 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. So what is our polynomial result? Simple, x to the power, this is 1, this is x, this is x square, this is x cube. So x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. Is it correct? See, x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. So this is what we are getting as polynomial coefficient. In this way, we can compute the multiplication of two polynomials using FFT. Okay, same only, we are doing basically multiplication of polynomial using convolution, and that convolution we are computing using FFT. So that we are saying this particular algorithm as polynomial multiplication using FFT algorithm. Okay, nothing else. Already I have explained this code in my previous video. You just check in the link given in the description for the detailed explanation. Thank you for watching.